or show you some tips on making cocktails for yourself at home.
Pino from Bar Hopscotch. Yeah. So I've been bartending for about 3-4 years. I really enjoy what I'm doing, so hopefully today I can share, you know, some things with you. So things you need for your home bar, let's say. Good to get a bar spoon, always a longer spoon because you need to reach into the bottom of the glasses. If you have guests around, so if you don't want to use your hand, you can use a long thumb. And a tablespoon would be very useful. Scooping pulps, butler. It's used to crush fruits and spices. We basically use 4 types of citrus fruits in the bar. So we start with the lemon. It's a very basic and neutral, fresh citrus sour. Compared to lime, because lime is bitter. It's a zesty bitterness. An orange, sweet citrus. And then grapefruit, bitter. But it's nice when you mix it with something floral. Basically cut your citrus into half. Get something like this from those like hardware stores, like the uncle type where they're bowls and stuff. Or siahuan. So for this one, basically the juice comes out from here. And you just slice up once again and then put it in there. Another essential is a simple syrup. It's basically 1 part caster sugar to 1 part water. How do we measure? We have jiggers, 2 types. This one is the common one, it's 30 ml to 45. This is for convenience sake. You want to use the 30 and then you want to sweep the 45. So you should hold it like this. It's called X jigger. So you can actually, you know, straight away, yeah, change the whatever, you know, to the setting you want. This is a shaker, tea to tea. There are a few types of strainer. It's a classic Hawthorne strainer. So you can see it actually has prongs. This is 4 prong. It helps sit onto the thing. And there are those without that goes right in. So once again, it's preference. And then they pop. So like little like berries and watermelon, they get caught in there. It's a base period because contract is 40%. Then lime juice. Then you just top up with soda. That's it. Yeah. So like you can do with a slice of like orange ribbon. And a simple touch to make it very good. Just press it gently like this. Add slices of cucumber. And then you do the crunchy piece again. I'll finish off with a bar trick for you. Because orange oils are actually flammable. So when you warm them up sufficiently, and you can smell it. So yeah, that makes the cocktail a lot more special. So for that balance, we use salt. So like sometimes you can preview your drinks while you're making it, right? You don't have to shake first because then you'll be too diluted for you to change. Okay, like mix it well. Lopet, full cream. Okay. When you keep your chocolate syrup chilled, right, you can also use this as a garnish for the inside of the glass.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, but if it's too warm, it'll be too runny. So you don't always have to do the whole thing. You just add. And then when you seal, you see a straight line.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so this will give you a nice vacuum. You seal in the center, it comes off easily. So one straight line and then it's like slanted to the side. Yeah. So for ladies, it's in my mind easier to throw it over your shoulder. So guys, you never like that. But when we first started using a glass, one's very heavy. So I always tell the girls, if you find it hard, throw it over your shoulders.
Okay.
Yeah, but many ladies shake very well, they shake like so you just shake about classically 10 to 15 seconds. And for boys, they shake a lot harder, so 5 to 8. Yeah.
Okay.
So when to stop? When it's all frosty, it actually sticks to my hand a little. Yeah. So I'm okay with some ice beads in this one. I'm gonna just strain out a nice contrast. We have like dehydrated orange that we made ourselves with a dehydrator. But to do this at home, you can actually use the oven at the lowest heat with the door open for like maybe about almost up to 12 hours.
Yeah.
You can get cute little treats like that from online.
Me?
Online. Yeah. Can you give it a try? So this is the one that gives it a bit of sweetness and the citrusness. A bit of chocolate. You see that we're using a little rinse of a baking whiskey. So you can use either Port Charlotte, Octomom, the nice black quarter, or any types of baking whiskey. So you can rinse your glass with it, meaning you take your glass. And then you put a bit of the spirit and then you just wash the glass with it. You can throw it out, the excess.
Yeah.
I like to keep it in.
Okay.
And then you start stirring a bit. So for this one, when you stop, right, you feel it. Don't put your hand here, okay, because it will warm up the drink. So there will be more dilution than you need. If you want to keep, you want to get it cold real fast with a little bit of dilution so that it's easy to go down. You don't want it to like, out. And serve it with a few ice cubes, like a whiskey in the box, but it's gonna take some time. And you get a nice big piece like that. Just give you a good feel and you get like very creepy feel for the decoration as well. Yeah. Stronger drink with the crack. Sake is unfiltered, yeah. So isn't really a point if you use clear sake. Yeah, something like Nigori would be better. Maple syrup, 15 ml. Squeeze some. Just one thing that drastically changes the flavor. Because usually like straight up drinks, you don't really want to taste the ice beads inside there.
Yeah.
I need to go down really for parties or what, you can even tie the name tags. It would be advisable to pre-tie it. But like for us, we decide on the spot like what colour we want it to be.